In this video, I will give an introduction to Kampala's air quality. Although the city has its own unique air quality dynamics, the topics that I will mention are illustrative of some other fast-growing cities, such as Nairobi in Kenya, also situated close to the equator. First of all, we know very little about the air quality in Kampala, but the sparse evidence we have suggests that the city is struggling with growing air quality concerns. What we know is based on two sources. Eyewitness reports by the inhabitants, as documented in various newspaper articles, and two monitoring studies initiated by scientists from the US, the Netherlands, and Uganda that were published in the recent years. Government-led initiatives that are in place in many other cities to monitor the air quality are absent in Kampala. Based on the monitoring studies, we can get some insight into which compounds and emissions are responsible for Kampala's air quality problems. Let's look at two of the major substances whose concentrations are regulated in many countries, particulate matter, or PM, and nitrogen dioxide, or NO2. These studies show that levels of particulate matter are very high in Kampala. During the dry season of 2013-2014, when the research was performed, PM2.5 concentrations varied between 100 and 160 micrograms per cubic meter. This is far above the limit of 10 micrograms per cubic meter, advised by the World Health Organization, which you see visualized here below as a red line. Such high concentrations of particulate matter are known to lead to significant increases in heart and respiratory diseases. The high levels of particulate matter measured in Kampala are comparable to those in Beijing, here shown in blue in the year 2014, when there was a major upheaval in the international press about smog in Beijing. The monitoring studies also showed that NO2 concentrations remain surprisingly modest over Kampala. High concentrations of this gas phase NO2 are caused by traffic, especially by the many vehicles with engines burning diesel and gasoline fuel. And Kampala is overflowing with old second-hand cars, known for their very high emissions of nitrogen oxides. But in 2014, NO2 concentrations in Kampala were only around 20 to 30 micrograms per cubic meter. This is lower than the average concentration in Amsterdam and well within the European norm, which the city of Amsterdam exceeded in 2016. One explanation for the low NO2 concentrations in Kampala is that most of the nitrogen oxides over the city are actually present in the form of nitrogen monoxide, or NO. This could well be the result of a chemical process called ozone titration. Near large sources of NO, such as at the Kampala measurement site next to a busy road, ozone has been affected by its chemical reaction with nitrogen oxide, forming nitrogen dioxide. Near the Kampala roadside, however, the ozone levels have become so low that there is no longer sufficient ozone around to convert NO to NO2. The measured ozone concentrations of only 11 micrograms per cubic meter, shown here in the box and whisker plot, for 6 measurement days support this explanation. But to be really sure if this mechanism is the reason for the low NO2 concentrations, we would need to take measurements of NO as well. And unfortunately, these have not been taken in Kampala. The particulate matter in Kampala consists mostly of carbon and dust. There are substantial dust emissions from the dense traffic driving on the many unpaved roads. The high carbon content in the aerosols indicates widespread, inefficient burning in Kampala. When organic material, often still wet, is burned at low temperatures, emissions of smoke, carbon monoxide and volatile organic compounds are high. Indeed, smoke from garbage burning and from indoor fuel burning frequently limits the visibility in Kampala. In summary, the air quality in Kampala is very poor. We saw that especially particulate matter may reach very unhealthy levels. This is the consequence of Kampala's massive urban growth and continuing economic development, resulting from the widespread burning of wood, charcoal and garbage, together with the strong emissions from cars driving on unpaved roads while burning gasoline. All this is putting a lot of pressure on the citizens' health. Yet there is a lack of scientific research and data on air quality in Kampala. So our understanding of anthropogenic emissions and their consequences is still limited. However, air pollution will be a major topic for a sustainable transition in Kampala, and air-related problems need to be addressed in full by local authorities, scientists, and citizens.